Hello and welcome to an amazing webinar on the right way to prepare for interview. Vajra India Technologies has provided training to more than 10,000 youths all over India. We are continuously working on our goal to provide internships to students to help them get practical exposure. Today, I, Rameek Kaur, welcomes Ms. Aishna Jaiswal, an MBA in Marketing and Finance from XIME Bangalore. She is passionate about bringing change and helping youths in structuring their career goals. She brings in consultancy experience from big forums like EY with a blend of BFSI from the current role. She is currently working at Envestnet Yodlee as a business analyst, and she has trained more than 1,000 plus students, and every one of them is placed in good MNCs. She is also an investment enthusiast and strongly believes that the good investment appetite is the need of the hour for youth India. And I would also like to tell that she also has a YouTube channel where she guides more than n number of students. And the name of the channel is Aishna Talks Line. And I'm very happy to welcome you here. Please guide our students.
Hello, everyone. Very good morning to all of you. Am I audible to everyone?
Yes, you are audible.
Yeah. So as Ramnik already gave you an intro about me, so I come here with a lot of experience and together with a passion to train youngsters to guide them through the issues they face in their career goals. And most of this motivation comes because of the struggles I faced when I was in your place and your seat. So today's session is around how and what you should do, because interviews are something which panics everyone who is in the final year, or even, you know, trust me, after we are into corporate working, still whenever we are planning to change a job, that same amount of panic comes in for us as well. So it's not something which only you guys go through. So today's video, I want to give you some basic tips around small things which you need to keep in mind, and that will help you in, you know, being more prepared, being more confident, being more structured in what you do when you are going for an interview. So I'll be presenting my screen and we'll take you through. Just give me a moment. Sorry, am I visible as well? I'm not sure.
Yes, you're visible, but your screen is not visible right now.
Yeah, I'm just sharing it.
Yes, the screen is visible now.
Yeah. Visible now? The PPT is visible, is it?
Yeah, it's visible.
Okay. So the first question which I want to put in front of all of you is, do you sit for any interview that comes your way? So if your answer is yes, you really need to go through these points which I'll be mentioning, because what happens is when we are sitting for a college placement, we are very desperate that, you know, we need to get a job. That is the only thing which is running in our mind. And see, when I was in my final year, I did the same mistake. Whatever was coming through, I was just going and sitting for interviews. But, you know, that is not, I will not say that, you know, you can rule out that option. Of course, we all want a good job and we don't want to miss any opportunity. So we do that. But we need to be a little more, you know, insightful about what kind of role, you know, what kind of company we are going to get into, because our mindset at that point of time is, you know, that we need to just get a job. We don't really care about, okay, what is the company about, what is the role about, and the second thing which we are much more worried about is what kind of package the company is giving us. So that these are the two things, you know, we want to ensure, and that's we randomly just sit for any interview. So what you can do is, you must like the role. you know, whenever you are in a college placement or you are you know, you are trying to get a job, change a job, you always have a small description handy. Any company will obviously define what you really want to, you know, what you will be getting into. So you should read that and try and understand. Because let's say you are doing, you are an engineer in a mechanical background, okay. But what happens is, you know, a CS company came in and they are giving us a very good package. So we just run behind that job. We don't really think about what kind of skill sets we have, what kind of interest areas we have. We don't really go much into it, that we go and research it out. That is the common problem which I've seen. So what happens is at that time, no worries. We will crack the interview. We will get the job also. Trust me, you will do that because companies are not very much into what skill sets you are bringing. What they want to look into is whether they can train you or not. And that they can very clearly, you know, identify by giving you some analytical questions, some kind of, you know, technical know-hows and what is your approach. They will see that and they know that you are a trainable employee. They will not really, you know, it will not really matter for them that what kind of specialization you had. Okay, so that is something which you need to do. So you need to be thorough about what is the role, and you cannot. So you can always reach out to, you know, people. So what happens is we think that, okay, we got a one PDF, one page, and in that they have written few things. Not all of it will be very clear to us. So what do we do then? We can do some kind of research around it. What is the most handy research for us is we always have an alumni group, maybe not a very structured one, but you will always have seniors and people around who have been working into such firms. If it is a repeat company on your campus, you can definitely reach out to anybody who is still there or has worked there. So what they will tell you is they will tell you the exact role, what it is, because you should never blindly believe that what is written on the JD will be what you will be doing. It is a very high level brief up which they give. Just like a formality. So you need to do that research, because you will crack the interview, you will go land into a job, but what you really want is you want to stay there, you want to grow there. So to do that, that is something you have to be you have to put in little bit of effort, so that you can do, reach out to your seniors, reach out to your you know, placement committee and people who are into this kind of things, and they know little bit about the role. Now, what happens is sometimes that company wouldn't be something which has visited your campus. That is also a possibility, right? Not all company will be a repeat company for you. So in those cases, what can you do is you can go and speak to someone in your family or some friend or who has a similar role, not necessarily the same company, but they might have a similar role. So there you can do a little bit of research. Secondly, okay, you don't have anybody in your circle who knows, and you are from a family where, you know, people are more into business. No one has landed into a service sector. So what do? You go to platforms like LinkedIn. There's a website, Glassdoor, where you can see where employees leave reviews about roles, about teams, what kind of experience they had. On LinkedIn, what you can do is you can search, you can connect with people, and people will help you. But what happens is back then when I was in college, we did not know that there is a path like this. We never knew that, okay, if I ask someone with an experience that, you know, give me some guidance, we just had a clear mindset that, okay, no one will have the time to, you know, respond to a college graduate. But that it doesn't work like that. Maybe you'll have to reach to 10 people. The first person might not respond to you. But if you do that little bit of effort, you will get some insights on, you know, what kind of role are you landing into? What is the true picture when you go inside the company? And that will definitely help you. It will not only help you in the start of the job, it will help you throughout your journey in that company. And, you know, in India, not too much of popularity is there on Glassdoor and stuff like that. But if you are taking roles outside India, there are so many more websites where you can get these inputs right from people who are working in that particular firm. So these are some things which, you know, you can go ahead with, and you can simply land into a better job. So what next is, now what is interview all about? What exactly your interviewer wants to know about you during the interview? So if you think that, you know, in a 1 hour interview, interviewer will know everything about you, that's next to impossible. And that really doesn't happen. They don't want to know 100% about you. Okay, so they will just pick few pointers from which they can analyze you, that whether you will be able to handle all that they want from you or not. So there are few things, if you take care of those, you will be very much, you know, in their to be hired list. You jump very quickly from not to be hired to the to be hired list. You don't have to be very, very good. You don't have to be an A+. You don't have to be a topper or anything like that. But what happens is, when we are in college, we feel, you know, my grades are not that great. You know, one of my electives, I did not score well. You know, that will be the only point, you know, they'll see and they'll just think about me. Okay, no, this candidate is, no, it is not like that. Trust me. So it's not that they want to test all of your knowledge. They don't want to see that whether you're an expert of the subject. They just want to see whether you can grasp things quickly, whether you can do what they want you to do in the job. And there is a hell lot of difference in what you study in colleges and what you do in the corporate. So please don't go with the mindset that only your grades are what is going. Maybe I think grades just help you, you know, to just clear that first eligibility round. Or maybe, you know, if the college is setting a particular criteria that if you have this in this CGPA only, then you can be eligible to sit in this interview. But, you know, when you enter the interview room, trust me, it is not your grades which, you know, make you go in that list of the employer. So don't go with that mindset, first thing. Now, when you go to a company, it's not that, you know, you just have to sit in front of the laptop and work. So I'm very good at the technical stuff. I'll handle everything. That is, of course, important. But there you go as a person, you go as an employee. And an employee is not only one who can just work. You have to be presentable. You have to talk to people. You should be able to handle meetings. You should be able to make PPTs. And there are a hell lot of things, you know, which you should have. So your personality definitely matters. So from my experience, I can say you can get more insights on these things. If you subscribe to my channel, I'll be putting more stuff around this, where, you know, I'll talk about things like, there are certain kind of role where your personality plays a greater role than your technicality. But definitely there are roles where your technical front has to be more strong. So all of this comes into picture when I say you that you have to do a little bit of research on the JD. The JD can clearly tell you which part of the interview should be your maximum focus on. But you have to make it a perfect blend. It cannot be only technical knowledge. It cannot be only personality. So it is a perfect blend of your personality, your knowledge. Third thing is your analysis, the way you analyze the situation. The situational questions are given only from this perspective, that they want to see anything comes to your plate, how do you handle it? What is your way of taking it? What is your approach? Because in corporate, nothing is going to be planned. Whatever comes to your plate, you know, it can be new. It can be something which nobody in your company or your team has seen before. So that is where they test you, that how do you handle any situation given to you? Okay. Next thing is, how do you communicate? That is something, you know, which plays a very, very major role. And when I say how do you communicate, it does not mean how good you are at English. So this is a common misunderstanding. People think that communication means I have to be very good at English. No, it is not at all like that. And especially the fact is, if you're a technical person, you might not be very good at, you know, vocal skills, because that is not something of your forte, right? Maybe in an MBA graduate or someone who is into, you know, a marketing role or something like that, they might be, you know, being trained on this thing. They might be, their course itself might give them n number of opportunities where they communicate, where they speak. So that thing comes into them. So that is what is expected from them. But when a technical person goes into an interview, it's not that, you know, they consider that, okay, no, this person has to be very fluent in English. They cannot make any grammatical mistake. If they do that, they are simply a no for us. No, it doesn't work like that. Because I have been into corporate. I have been on the other side of the table. I have taken interviews for freshers, and I know what is the mindset behind the table, what they want to see in you. So if you have this thing that I'm not good at spoken English, I cannot crack an interview, you are wrong. You need to have a little bit of skill, of course. And I think that all of us has, if we are into a BTEC or into any college where we are doing our graduation, I think we all have that kind of, you know, a communication skill, which is required for, you know, to start your career. Okay. Now, five things I'll quickly tell you what you should definitely focus on. Whatever is your profile and your company, you should be very well aware of it. You should not blindly go, you know, you prepared for a Wipro interview. You should not go and sit in TCS interview blindly. Okay, both are IT firms. I prepared for one, the other one I'll crack easily. No, it doesn't work like that. Take that at least 1 hour before your interview day to, you know, just research about the company a little bit. Because if you hire someone for your business, would you not expect that person should know what I do, right? So when we are into college placements, and even now when I was changing jobs, I was doing this mistake in the beginning. I was like, okay, one sector I've prepared, doesn't matter which company it is. But you know, every company has a little bit of brand value, a little bit of a difference which they create in the market. So you have to be, you know, a little bit aware that what the company is and what the profile is. If there is slight variation, you should know that shows how serious you are. That shows, you know, you have read through, you have valued that piece of paper which was given to you before you go for that interview. Okay. Second thing, you have to take care of your dressing, because that is your first impression. The interviewer does not know what you did, whether you are a topper, whether you are, you know, head of any committee, whether you are the most performing student in the college. They really don't know, and they really don't care. So all of you are on the same ground. The way you look, the way you carry yourself will make a difference. Okay, so take care of that point. Your CV. Now, this is something which is, after you enter into the interview, it goes on. This is the first thing, you know, after some behavioral questions, they will ask around like, tell me about yourself, or little bit, you know, to make you at ease. They will come to your CV, because that is where your technical grilling or things about what you want to show to them comes into picture. Because CV is a document which you are giving in their hand. It is totally in your control. You are giving them pointers that I am good at this. You ask from whatever you want. So that is something which is expected, that ye document to aapki taraf se aaya hai. Now you need to be thorough with what you have written. Because if you fail there, it is a clear case of that you are just bluffing, and what you are just for the sake of giving that, you give it. So never write anything which you have not done. If you are writing anything slightly in a different way, in a more presentable way, be very confident on it. Okay. And make sure your CV is very short, not more than one page, and it contains only the points which you want to highlight. It should not have things of everything what you have done. That's where again that point comes in, where you have to know your JD. Because if the role is about coding, you cannot go and say that I was the placement committee head and I brought in so many companies and this and that. That shows your marketing skill, right? That doesn't show that you are good at coding. So your CV should read there that I have done this college assignment where I was supposed to do certain kind of codings, and we won a prize because of the way we worked on this thing. So that is how you need to structure your CV differently. So don't be under the impression that I'll just make one CV and that I'll take for every interview. If you do that, you are yourself entangling yourself. So don't do that mistake. From my experience, I have done that. So I'm telling you this, that don't do that, because it messed up a couple of my interviews before I could realize that something is going wrong. So don't do that. Your body language. This is something where you are, you know, analyzed. How will you do when you are in my office? How are you going to, you know, stand in a meeting? How are you going to talk to someone who is senior to you? How from your body language can you show respect? How can you walk in a meeting room? How can you walk out of meeting room? So these kind of things are analyzed through this. This is not something which you have to speak. Without speaking, you need to show that you are good at this. So that part of you is analyzed using this. So this is not something which is only for, you know, that you need to be disciplined just for the interview. It is something which they are seeing beyond when they hire you. So take care of that. These are like very small things, which what happens in the pressure of interview, we really don't care about it much, or maybe we are so much panicked that we don't really have time to, you know, think about this or be conscious about these things. But if we think about it before, maybe this will automatically start coming in back end mein aapko aisa lagega ki okay, this is something, you know, I know I have to worry about when I am in an interview. So automatically you will start paying some attention to that part. But if you don't think about it only, it will never come to you. Because when we are in the interview room, pressure is the only thing which is, you know, in us. And we humans behave very differently when they are under pressure than the way they behave when they are in normal circumstances. So that is why we need to think these points beforehand itself. Now, the last one is the behavioral questions. So behavioral questions are of many types, but what happens is these do not have any structured answer. You cannot just rote it and go and say there, because these are something which needs structuring, but all of these questions will be aligned the kind of personality you carry. So recently, like on my channel, you can go and see, I put one video for this particular questions. I'll be putting more of behavioral questions. But if I give you one example, tell me about yourself is a behavioral question. So there, if you know, what was my first experience? I never thought that I cannot answer this question, because this is something, tell me about yourself. What is the big deal here? You know, they're asking about me. So of course I can answer that. But trust me, if you don't structure this question, it is not just like any question they ask. So this question has a lot of much more, you know, deeper understanding. So if you go and watch that video, you will go and you will understand that what exactly, because interview, you have to answer only what they want to listen. You can say hundreds of things about tell me about yourself, but that is not really what they are interested in. So that is where structuring comes into place. So behavioral questions need preparation. Don't do that mistake that these are generic questions. These are just like, you know, communication strike karne ke liye, just a warm up question. No, there is an agenda when they ask you these questions. Okay. Apart from behavioral, you will have analytical questions. You will have technical questions. Analytical wo ho gaya jahan pe aapko situational scenarios diya jayega aur dekha jayega ki how you are handling it. Technical is core from your subject. जो भी आपकी डिग्री है उसके अराउंड दे विल आस्क यू टेक्निकल क्वेश्चंस. सो दीज आर थ्री काइंड ऑफ क्वेश्चंस प्राइमरली इंटरव्यूअर विल प्ले विथ यू व्हेन दे आर यू नो ट्राइंग टू ग्रिल यू अक्रॉस डिफरेंट पैरामीटर्स. सो दीज फाइव थिंग्स यू शुड डेफिनेटली कीप इन योर माइंड. एंड कॉन्फिडेंस ऑफ कोर्स दैट हैज टू बी थ्रू आउट राइट फ्रॉम द टाइम यू एंटर द रूम टिल द टाइम यू लूज यू विल बी लीविंग द रूम. सो यू हैव टू शो दैट कॉन्फिडेंस. You might have, you know, in middle of the interview panic, you were not able to answer one question. Of course, you will go a little bit, you know, there. But again, if you think through about it, you have to remind yourself that, no, okay, it is one question is gone and that question is gone. But you cannot lose your confidence ki baki ke question also you don't answer. So don't do that. Because I remember when I was taking an interview, one candidate was very nervous. First question itself, he did not answer well. But the best part why we hired him was he came back very strong. He was so strong in the next question that you cannot think, you know, that this person was so messed up the start of the interview. So that is what, you know, we look into. And that is where we see that. Imagine you are in a company meeting and something happened with your first slide. You couldn't start well and you have clients sitting in front of you. You will go into immense amount of panic. But what your manager will want is you come back stronger. So the rest seven slides should be better and so much better that the client forgets that the first slide was a disaster. So this is a skill they see. So don't think that ek question gaya to mera interview chala gaya. No, they will see that how strongly you are coming back. So confidence ko pure interview mein leke chaliye, not like ki beech mein chala gaya to uske baad ka interview is gone. Don't do that. Okay. So now it's open to you. You can ask me questions. This was just a brief up of what all I could cover in a very short duration. But of course, you guys will be having multiple questions, so that will be a better interaction for me. So, Saurav? Hello?
Yes, I'm just putting the questions. Just one second.
Yeah.
Okay, someone is asking from the chat. Says telling that EY is a big forum, so to get into that, what C should do?
Okay, so what is the background of the candidate?
She is a CSE background, she belongs to CSE background.
Okay. EY is basically a consultancy firm primarily, but of course every firm needs technical people as well. So for any consultancy firm, not only the big fours, if you go for any, you know, international banks or any place where there is something like that being done, apart from your technical skills, you have to be very, very particular about your presentation skills, because that is something which is of very much importance there. And your dressing, your behavioral aspects become very strong point in your interview. Plus, technical part will be there, but people who will be interviewing you will be primarily working into a domain where they expect a lot of you have a lot of client facing roles there actually. So they will be expecting you to be very good at English. You have to be very good at the way you carry yourself. You have to be very familiar with a formal kind of carrying dress, like dress codes, which are you know, very presentable, very very good to have in a very strict corporate environment. So any kind of role where you have client facing role, that is something which is expected, nevertheless which company you are in, you are appearing for. But any big four specifically, you have to you know, be very particular about that, apart from your technical skills.
There is one more question from Chiranjeevi. How can you overcome fear when I am facing interview?
So if one of my videos, I have started with this point, because there is a lot of connection between the confidence level you have and the kind of preparation you have done. So if you have a very strong preparation, the fear factor will automatically come down. So before, whatever points I was telling you now, those are something, you know, which come after you have done your preparation. So you have to be very thorough with the subject matter which you are where you are going to work. So when you see your JD, you have to be very thorough with the role. You have to do additional research around it. You don't have to just rely on what you have read in your college. You have to read through, you know, similar kind of roles. Today's era, so much is available on the internet. People are writing so many things around. So, you know, you can just read, corporate blogs are there where you can go and read the experiences. You have to find that role, what kind of expectation is there. So if you pick those points and focus on those kind of things which are actually being expected from you, your preparation will be very strong, and that will automatically bring in a lot of confidence. So you can focus on that. Yeah.
One more question from Sabuz is that, can you please tell me the questions can be asked in IT company interview?
So IT company, so what I have to tell you is, as I said, that every interview will be distributed across three things: your technical questions, which will be from your specialization. So if a typical IT company like a TCS or a Wipro they will mostly have an aptitude test in the beginning itself, where they will see that, you know, they don't blindly go with, you know, you got very good grades, so they are okay with it. So normally they will have an aptitude test in the beginning where they'll test you, and they'll filter out candidates who score certain amount of, you know, they have certain criteria. If you meet that, only then you go for the final interview. Even for MBAs, they do that. But for technical people, definitely they will do that. So it doesn't matter, your college scores will not be a defining thing. So you have to be good at that. And once you clear those rounds, you go for the like the face-to-face interviews where you will be grilled on, you know, analytical questions and behavioral questions both. So you have to pretty much prepare all the three aspects even there. To qualify, you have to be good with your aptitude tests, like simple as your engineering entrance tests or a CAT or a MAT, something like that, where different parameters will be checked.
I would request you, kindly, you can share your YouTube channel. You can show our students the YouTube channel of yours so that in future they can connect with you and can take guidance from you. Because I would like to tell about Ms. Asna Jaiswal. She has trained more than 1,000 plus students in the corporate fields, and many of them are placed in very good MNC. So I'd request if you share your YouTube channel link with the students so that they can take guidance from you. It would be very good for us.
Yeah, definitely. Like you can search as Aishna's talk line. I'll also share the link with Saurav. He will be sending it out to all of you, the link, the clickable link you'll get. But like if you search it with that name, my channel name is Aishna's talk line, you will definitely be able to find it. So yes, you can. I have already made a couple of videos on interviews. Of course, in a live session, I cannot cover everything, but you can go. Those are very detailed and structured videos. I have given examples. So if I tell you that there's a question called tell me about yourself, I cannot just tell you, you know, that, okay, you should see this. No fresher will understand things like that. Maybe someone with an experience might, but if you're a fresher, you need to hear that, okay, this is a sample answer. Then you can build on it. Okay, according to myself, how do I modify it? So in my videos, I will give you live examples. Recently, I even started collecting examples from people who are working, trust me, and see, and I'm using those examples in my videos to show you that, okay, you are not the only one who does not know how to structure this answer. So I'll give you those examples where people have answered it like that. And then I tell you, how do you structure it? What kind of pointers you include? So you can get all those inputs from my channel.
I think your screen is mirroring. Can you just stop presenting so that viewer can see you?
Yeah.
Okay, there are some more questions. Pratima is asking, what to do when you get nervous in front of HR? What should we supposed to do?
Okay, that's a question which I'm surprised to listen. You won't get nervous in front of an HR. Where you'll get nervous is when you are in front of the panel. So how it works is, normally you will have an analytical round beforehand. A company spoke will come to either your college, or if you are a lateral hire, they'll send you across those aptitude tests. There nobody, you don't have to face anybody. You'll just give the test, you get the results. Once you're eligible, they will call you for the panel interview. Panel interview is the place where you get nervous, because that is where people are sitting, questioning you, multiple people are testing you across, you know, different parameters. So there itself, you'll have to take care of these things like body language, how you speak, how you handle your panicness and all of that. HR is something which happens once you're hired. So once the panel will approve that ye candidate is suitable enough, of HR round mein, they will send you there. Now, HR will never do anything where, you know, they reject you. HR ka kaam ye hota hai ki aapko technical logon ne hire kar liya hai. Now they have to just, unka agenda ye hota hai ki is candidate ko mujhe kam se kam paison mein hire karna hai. So what they will ask you is about your CTC. Okay, they'll try and negotiate ki agar college mein ho to aapko pata hota hai ki haan, kyunki college ki committee ye discuss kar li hoti hai pehle company se ki aapko itna to dena hi hai hamare students ko, right? But lateral mein aisa nahi hota hai. Agar aapne ek bar experience kiya, khud se aap job search karo, this is not going to happen. You have to fight for your worth. So वहाँ पे HR will do that game with you. वहाँ पे आपको nervous होने की कोई ज़रूरत नहीं है. अगर आप already दो तीन interview में qualify कर चुके हो, तो you will play the game with on your side. It's the ball is in your court. You can just ask above it, and that and all with come with experience. So don't worry about HR round at all. Maximum is they'll ask, you know, location kya hai, whether you are flexible to travel, whether, you know, job requirement might ask you to go here and there, stay. For example, someone asked about EY, right? So EY mein client facing roles mein kya hota hai? They'll ask you that you have to travel. So they'll ask you questions like, you know, are you more of a, do you value too much of your personal life, whether, you know, you don't want to travel. So those are the things they'll ask you. So don't be nervous about that at all. If you are reaching the HR on, matlab you are fit enough, baki negotiation you can do. So don't worry about that.
Okay, one, I think most of you have same queries, I think, questions. There's one more question. One second. Yeah, from Avinab side, should we go first for off-campus placement or get placement from outside?
Off-campus? Sorry?
Yeah. Should we go first for off-campus placement or get placement from college?
So, okay. You have to analyze what kind of placement record your college has and a little bit of analysis on how the market is going, okay? So if your college promises some 70%, 80%, 90% placement, the only reason why you'll go for off campus is if you can get a better package. Normally, if you're in a good college, you don't need to really worry because place committee is something where, you know, the companies have a rapport with. They don't want to spoil it because they are a continuous source of employees and freshers, because hiring freshers is very easy. Trust me, company saves a lot of cost when they hire freshers. So they don't want to spoil that reputation with your college. So they will hire you if the college is confident. So these things you need to be in sync with your placecom and a little bit about how your college's history has been. But if you see that college is only promising for 50% placements and your grades are not in the top listers, you should definitely start with off campus as well. See, what happens is, how does it give you a backseat? It is giving you just more and more confidence. If you get an off campus placement, you will not imagine when you have a job in your hand, you perform extremely well in the other interview. Because as humans, you know, everyone has that psychology. Am I at a loss? If we are afraid only when we know we have nothing. So if you have anything, that will give you so much more confidence to appear for more and more interviews. And why lose that opportunity? You're paying such a big fee. Why will you not have the college get you placed? So parallelly, dono kariye. अगर मार्केट डाइसी है, इफ यू सी दैट यू नो आईटी सेक्टर इज इम्पैक्टेड, गवर्नमेंट का कुछ ऐसा आया है कि जॉब एट्रिशन बहुत हाई है, अभी कोविड के वजह से लॉट ऑफ थिंग्स हैपेंड, सो थोड़ा सा कैलकुलेटिव डिसीजन रखिए. इफ यू फील लाइक दैट, यू हैव टू ट्राई ऑन ऑल साइड्स, सो दैट इज हाउ यू विल बी एबल टू डिसाइड ऑन दैट.
देयर इज वन लास्ट क्वेश्चन फ्रॉम ओम प्रकाश साइड. मैम, कैन यू प्लीज टेल अस इन इंटरव्यू व्हाट टाइप ऑफ प्रिपरेशन वी हैव टू डू.
What type of
preparation we have to do for interview?
Preparations will be on different grounds. Preparations will be first thing which you have to do throughout your college, especially in your final year, when whichever year you're going to appear, is be thorough with your technicalities. You don't need to be master of every subject, but you know, see your marks card, okay? If you have performed really well in a subject and your marks are saying that you are good at this, be sure that you are good at that. Because the interviewer might not, you know, expect ki tum sare subjects mein A-lister ho, not required. But agar college ne bola hai ki aap isme A-lister ho, to make sure that, see, exams mein we all know, right? We prepare, we get marks also, not a big deal. But are we really good at that subject? That we need to ensure, because interview will not understand that how did you score that. They will see that in your CV or in your mark sheet, kyunki fresher ke liye mark sheet bahut important hota hai. So you have to do that. Apne strong points pe work kariye. Don't try to master all the subjects. Okay. Second thing is, aap online sessions attend kariye. YouTube channels mein jahan pe log live session mein ye sab discuss kar rahe hain, un sari cheezon ko, waise cheezon ko wo batayenge. Industry experts se, you know, exposure ko badhaiye, because there you will get inputs ki aapko kya karna hai in terms of, जो भी मैंने ऐसे फैक्टर्स बताए जो आपके टेक्निकलिटी से रिलेटेड नहीं है, बट आपके प्रेजेंटेशन में आपको एक पोटेंशियल एम्प्लॉय बनाने के लिए बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट है. तो साइडवेज ये सारी चीज़ों की भी रिसर्च को करिए. कुछ बुक्स आते हैं, आई कैन शेयर दोज लिंक्स, यू नो, इन माई वीडियोज फर्दर. इफ आई गेट मोर रिक्वेस्ट, आई कैन गिव यू दोज लिंक्स वेर यू विल गेट सर्टन पॉइंटर्स. बट यू नो, आज वेन आई वॉज इन कॉलेज, बुक्स यूज टू प्ले अ वेरी बिग रोल, बट आज के डिजिटल वर्ल्ड में कोई बुक्स नहीं देखता है. यू हैव सो मच ऑफ इन्फो ऑनलाइन, यू नो, यू जस्ट हैव टू बी अ रिसर्चर, ट्रस्ट मी, एंड यू विल गेट मोस्ट ऑफ इट फॉर फ्री, सम ऑफ इट फॉर अ कॉस्ट. सो डू दैट, डोंट जस्ट थिंक दैट, यू नो, दो तीन लोगों से बात करके आई विल बी द, यू नो, आई विल बी लाइक ऑन टॉप ऑफ एवरी इंटरव्यू. दैट डजंट हैपन.
सो आई थिंक दैट्स ऑल द क्वेश्चन. सो thank you, Ms. Asna, for coming here at our channel and discuss so much valuable things with our learners. We are really glad to be with you. And kindly please share your YouTube channel so that they can get connected with you.
Yeah, You need to in the chat, can I ping the link to all of them? Will it be visible for everyone?
Just send me, I will share them in on our WhatsApp group.
Okay, I'll share it with you then. Okay, after the call. And also, I'm little, first of all, in the beginning, sorry, I couldn't say that. So to all of you who joined before me, I'm really sorry. I was a little late due to some technical glitch. I was fixing it with Saurav. So sorry for that. And see, I am not here, you know, to, so I just want to, I mean, Saurav, do we have some 5 minutes?
Yeah, sure, definitely.
Okay. So what I also want to tell is, see, I have been working for 5 years now, and it's not only during the job that I faced a lot of challenges, even in college. So what I, when I was in college, I was, all of these things, this digital era and all of that was very much, you know, it just coming into things were just coming. And we were not very much, we are from, I am from 90s, okay. And 90s kids are not that, they weren't so blessed to have these kind of exposures. So that's how I thought of starting this channel. All the while I used to think that, you know, I want to help people. I want to, be there when they need a help. So that's how this channel was born. So it's not that, you know, on my channel, you'll just find educational content. Education, job, all of this is a part of my life. And I want, and there are so many other things which happen in our life, where we need to help each other. We need to share our experiences. So that's how I started this channel, because I just want to be there for someone when I wanted someone to be there for me. So that's how you'll get a lot more content on my channel apart from just the education stuff. And I look forward so that you all give me a lot of input, so that, you know, any YouTuber always wants that, because we want to make content which people really want. So your comments, your inputs will definitely play a great role for me. So just do that, and I hope to, you know, make more and more content.
So thank you once again for being here, for taking your valuable time and sharing the content with us.
Thanks, Saurav. Thanks for, you know, giving me this opportunity to interact with students and, you know, give them that help which I wanted to. So thank you so much for that.
So guys, that's all for the today's session. I hope every one of you have really enjoyed a lot. So how you will receive your certificates of participation, we will share you in groups. Okay, so that's all from our side. Thank you again, Ms. Asna, for coming here.
Thank you.
Thank you.